magic. Love doesn't make people unhappy, it makes them happy.
Guilty, that's what I can't bear. The albatross around your neck. Like in the Ancient Mariner, instead of a cross, an albatross around my neck was hung.
What's that?
What's what?
Shadows on the wall.
Now, for somebody with such a clear conscience, you're very big.
Trick of the light, I expect.
Mm.
Who opened the door? I remember shutting it.
The catch is loose. I'll fix it one day.
Oh, how wonderful to be married.
Mm.
To have someone to do things around the house. I do so want this house to be perfect.
Mm.
Ah. Shall I do a second coat? It's only Wendy's room.
You know, I don't think we should have this room, Harriet, and that Wendy have the one next door.
But this is the worst room in the house. She's only coming at weekends.
Well, on school holidays. I mean, I don't want her feeling second best after what's been done to her.
Happened to her? You fret too much about broken homes. I come from a broken home and there's nothing wrong with me. Welcome.
Why did you say that?
The door opened, so I welcomed the unseen guest.
Perhaps we're going. I'm coming.
I never thought of that. Goodbye, then.
Put your slippers on.
Can't find them. Can I light the gas fire?
No. I can't afford it.
Dad'll pay the bill.
Mm. Ho, ho, ho.
The curtains won't me. Why are they waving?
Drafts.
I'm frightened. Can I get into your bed?
It's time to get up.
Please. I don't want to go to school. I don't feel well.
You really ought to.
I just don't feel very well.
Hmm.
Well, I don't suppose one day will make any difference in the great scheme of things.
Does that mean I can stay home?
Yes.
Can I have French toast for breakfast?
If there's an egg. How did that happen?
Drafts.
No jet.
It's awful. Wouldn't you do better as a producer or a director or something, not a writer?
Can a leopard change his spots?
It's so uncertain. You never know from one minute to the next whether you're rich or poor. Who's that from?
Anne, I'm afraid.
What does she want? Money?
Yes. Gas bill.
You pay her a monthly cheque. She's supposed to pay the gas out of that.
It's arguable.
Oh, you are so soft with her. Why doesn't she go out to work? I do.
She has a child. You don't.
Oh, I can't bear it. The hardness in your voice, it isn't fair. Why can't we just be happy? I dread the mail in the morning in case there's something out from her. Why can't it just be you and me? Would you love me more if I had a baby?
I couldn't love you more than I do.
We have scrambled eggs and toast for breakfast. And orange juice. And a tablecloth with little pink flowers on it.
I expect you do, my dear.
She says I can stay all week. Not just weekends.
Does she? What do you say?
I say no thank you. They always have the builders in. Bang, bang, bang. No peace.
Glad she can afford it, I'm sure. Sometimes it gets cold in here for no reason at all. Of course, it's very damp. Good enough for me and Wendy? Of course. We're just rejects. If we died of pneumonia, it'd be that much more for her.
Of course, if Wendy is fool enough to prefer Anne's dump to our house, then bad luck, Wendy. I give her up. She's more her mother's child than Morris's. As for me, I can't get pregnant. It's terrible. It isn't fair. Anne did. Why can't I? Shut the window, Audrey's cold. Now that I'm pregnant, I feel warm all the time. Even in here, such a difficult room to leave.
Yes, it's the high ceiling.
It used to be our bedroom. And I'd swear we always got bad dreams in it.
Perhaps it's haunted.
Oh, don't put ideas into Hattie's head. She's very susceptible.
We could do a table wrapping, or a glass, you know, with the alphabet around the outside.
Thank you. But
thank
if there's anything, I'd rather not know.
Harriet's motto through life.
And I wouldn't want you to unleash anything. This is going to be the nursery.
Oh, more changes? I don't know how you can afford it.
Well, we can't keep the poor little thing in a drawer. Though I think Morris would like us to.
Hattie just likes moving the furniture around.
Don't call me Hattie. I never seem to get it exactly right. The answer always seems to be just around the corner, but never quite here. I think we should build an extension.
Yes.
That will need planning permission and £2,000 or £3,000, and I don't know which will be the most difficult.
Actually, we tried to get planning permission.
We could sell Anne's house and raise the money.
Well, that's Wendy's inheritance with sitting tenants. At the moment, it's absolutely worthless.
Not altogether. It would fetch enough. And what about my child's inheritance?
Cyril, Audrey, I'm sorry. We always seem to air our problems in front of you.
We quarrel more in this room than in any other in the house.
That was a quarrel?
Yes. Disgraceful.
You should hear ours.
Walls shake.
We
only ever quarrel about Anne. Do you know, I've never seen her. Amazing how one unseen person can do so much to spoil a life.
She might say the same about you.
Oh, stop defending her.
That Hattie, you are clumsy.
I am not clumsy. It did it by itself. And don't call me Hattie.
Blame it on her condition.
Thank you, sir.
Pour some white wine on. It removes the stain.
Is it really?
Yes.
Brains as well as beauty. So young.
Morris, I don't wish you'd get the catch fixed. You've been saying you will for years, and you never do.
Our baby. No, we'd miss your income too much, Hattie. Things aren't good for me.
Oh, don't call me Hattie. It's condescending.
It's meant to be affectionate. The Reds' friend's house came today.
We should have gone to court. Forced a sale. But you were too kind-hearted. So now I have to go out to work to pay for the rates of your ex-wife's house.
And for your extravagant tastes, one way or another, Harriet.
Other people get decorators in? You can't think what I've saved you.
You've made things very nice.
Oh, stop humouring me. This house will never be nice. I want to move.
No.
Then no, I won't go out to work. Anne's your responsibility, not mine. Why don't you write something different, more popular? I know you can do it. You're not a great writer, Morris. I mean, you're very good, but you're not Tolstoy. Why not face up to it? At least try and make some money, then we can be happy again.
Green.
I want to be.
So do I.
This room, you see. Always this room. The quarreling room. Something's woken her.
Oh, perhaps it was the shadows.
What shadows?
What were shadows moving this room?
Yes. I expect that's it.
No sooner faced than gone.
Husband. She tried to steal my child. She's a murderess. She killed my marriage. He's not happy with her, you know. Takes more than long legs and a pretty face to make a man happy. He might come back to me one day.
You can't still think that.
Why not?
They're married. They've got a child.
So was I married? So did I have a child. What did that mean?
You don't want him.
I might. I'm waiting for something. I don't know what. Sometimes I think I ought to get out, get myself a job, but what can I do? Anything I was ever trained for was getting myself a husband, and I wasn't much good at that. I lost him. Or rather, she came along and thought, I'll have that, and fluttered her eyelashes and took him.
You've got to think of something else. This isn't healthy. On and on. It gets worse, not better. It all happened 5 years ago.
5 years? What's 5 years? I was married for 12. I went out working all those years, you know, so that he'd get himself started as a writer. He'd sit, just where you are now, scribbling away. I never complained. I just wanted to help. I get cleaning jobs, anything. I was even a model at an art school. He didn't like that. Well, I didn't mind. It was for him. When he finally made it, when he became what he wanted to be, a writer, I wasn't the right kind of wife for him, was I?
Can't you get out of this place? It can't be good for you.
He'd love that. Then he'd sell. He used to say this place was investment for Wendy. He's forgotten all that now. No. I'll never leave. Never. He won't get rid of me.
If you ask me, it's haunted down here.
Haunted? What by? The ghost of past happiness? Oh, don't make me laugh.
I wish I could.
Oh, poor, poor Harry. You're getting fed up with me, aren't you?
Nothing that happens now matters to you at all. Only what happened then. You married to Morris. Harriet coming along, Wendy.
Coming along? Oh, well, that's one way of putting it. Why should she have so much and me so little? I'm his real wife. I don't believe in divorce. Why should she live in comfort with Morris in her bed and me live down here in the damp and cold, hmm?
With me in your bed? Yes, well, I can see it doesn't compare.
I'm sorry. Something just won't let me let it go.
Perhaps you should see a doctor.
Oh, I have. He gave me pills for depression. I got very sick.
Or a psychiatrist. Or a priest.
I've seen a lot worse. You want paint or wallpaper?
Whatever you want. Just so it feels warm.
Wallpaper, then?
It used to be our bedroom. Then the dining room, then the nursery. And now it's Wendy's room, whenever she comes, which is almost never. I did my best with her, but she's her mother's daughter. No, don't do that.
Why do you always keep me off?
Because I'm married and I love my husband. You're very embarrassing, Toby. I wish you wouldn't.
You know you love us. You're flattered. And you and Morris are totally unsuited. Don't tell me you've always been faithful.
Of course I have.
You must be mad. Why?
He's my husband.
And he's faithful to you?
Of course.
Good heavens.
You have a terrible reputation, Toby. You make passes at all the wives and daughters of all the houses you do up.
Yes. That's why they ask me. You too.
No. I take marriage very seriously, Toby.
Plaster's damp won't hold a thing. You realize this whole outside wall will have to be stripped down from the plaster. Not cheap. With having your roof looked at, you might have a loose time. They've always been this damp.
Yes.
Probably your roof. Had you thought about making this room into a bathroom? Best thing for it.
Well, what about the expense? He still doesn't like spending money.
I suppose you're a suitable wife for a successful writer of feature films.
Of course I am.
You have to think of these things as men rise in the world.
I wouldn't demean myself by so much as considering it.
Damn! What
is it? Oh. No. It's...
just a washer. Nothing that idiot Toby did ever really worked. Oh, darling.
No, don't. Just let me wash this out first. You shouldn't have followed me.
It was just polite.
People will start thinking things.
They do already.
Not Hattie.
Oh, Hattie. Hattie's too thick-skinned to notice an elephant in her new utility room.
I know. Poor Morris, it must be dreadful for you.
I wouldn't be writing all this rubbish if it wasn't for her. I used to be passably good.
You still are. You're a very important writer, Morris. You don't seem to realize it.
Do you know, I don't know what I like most. The things you say. Or the mouth you say them.
I still feel bad about Hattie all the same.
I'm glad. You ought. She never felt anything for poor Annie. Not a flicker of guilt, ever. Oh, I want you to have my baby, Audrey.
We can't talk about that here, now. In a bathroom.
A very expensive bathroom. I can't stand all those boring trendies downstairs.
What are those funny shadows on the wall?
Really? Oh, you always get them, yeah. Hattie says this room is haunted. I don't like this house. Never have. In a year or two, I'll be able to work anywhere in the world. Los Angeles, Hawaii, south of France. You can take your pick. Just be patient. And wait a little. Hattie and the child can have this house.
I don't see why she should.
People talk behind her back. Everybody knows but her. People laugh at her. And Audrey and father, they practically hold hands under her nose. It's been going on for years. I don't know whether father's wicked or just innocent.
I don't know if you could call him innocent. He just never gives up.
Audrey can make him do whatever she wants.
Good. Harriet's turn.
Oh, it's all so long ago. Can't you forgive her? You're doing all right. You're better off without him.
You think so? You think a woman is better off without a husband? How can she be?
Well, I'm never going to get married, that's for sure.
She spoiled your life, too.
Well, I shall tell her. Someone has to. I can't bear it.
Yes. You do that.
I didn't want to hurt you. But she's right for me, Hattie. She understands my work. You never did. All you ever wanted was my money, and you know that's true.
I love you.
You don't know the meaning of the word. All you ever wanted was what wasn't yours.
Why do you talk about me? Why do you tell me what I feel? What gives you that right?
I'll look after you.
Yes. As you looked after Anne.
Well, I was guided by you, Hattie.
It was different.
How?
Look, don't pick quarrels with me now. There's nothing left of my life.
You can stay here. I'm not forcing you to leave.
I just want to get out of this house. I hate it. I always have.
Well, where will you go?
I don't know.
Because if you do go, it would be practical for Audrey just to move in. We sort out the financial details later.
doors open again. You never did fix that catch.
She's unfaithful to him. Well, he's nearly 60. He never was that much good in bed. Do you know we've wasted our lives revolving round a man?
Well, I was brought up to believe that any man was better than no man at all. And that all women were in competition. And after what I did to you, I couldn't let go of the idea that I loved him. Love was the only justification of my cruelty to you. I'm sorry.
I blamed you for what I did to Wendy. She didn't have a cheerful childhood. I could have made it so much better if I tried. But I got self-pity for myself, hatred for you, firmly between my teeth, chewed away at it for years. I made no attempt to understand myself or you. I'm sorry.
I think back a lot over those years. I remember scenes quite clearly. I make myself think of them to show me where I went wrong. I remember when Morris and I first painted that terrible room. It was a symbol of myself. I was never satisfied. I knew there was another truth. I used to think that room was haunted.
I used to think the same about this one until I understood what it meant. It was me now watching me then. Trying to tell myself something so that I wouldn't waste my life.
Perhaps it was the same in my house. Myself remembering me with sorrow for what I was and need never have been. Myself observing me. I really am so sorry, Anne.
Never mind. We could forget the past, think about the future. We used to get terrible drafts in this room. Not anymore. If anything, it's warmer. Open the window.